friends. Actually, the word monsoon has come from Arabian word, Arab, called mausim, something like this. Mausim, I think, mausim. Actually, mausim is an Arab word. In those days, the Arab travelers used to come to India for trade, Arab travelers, mostly Kerala. As Arab travelers, mostly they travel in the Arabian Sea. Arab travelers from Arabian Sea, they used to come to India and again go back from India. While traveling, they observed that the Arabian Sea or whatever, the Indian Ocean, has, if this is India, this is Indian Ocean, Arabian Sea, part of Indian Ocean, the Arab travelers, while they are coming to India, Arab travelers, they found that from May to September, they found winds in this direction. May to September, they found winds in this direction. October to March, they found winds in this direction, see. So the Arab travelers, the traders who came to India through Arabian Sea, they observed that the direction of wind is changing between the May to September, it is southwest. It is coming from southwest. October to March, it is coming from northeast. So they were the people who identified that it is, mausim. They called it mausim. That's why later it became monsoon. Now friends, monsoon can be defined as, seasonal reversal of wind. Seasonal reversal. Friends, seasonal reversal means in one season, winds blow one direction. Other season, they will reverse. Direction will reverse. That is called monsoon. Seasonal reversal of wind. However, friends, see, I just now explained you the Mediterranean climate. That is also seasonal reversal only. I explained about the climate at 60 degrees north. That is also seasonal reversal of winds. But they are not called monsoon. The reason is that to call it as monsoon, it requires some more criteria like differential heating of land and ocean, which I'll explain now. Differential heating of land and ocean. This is another criteria required to be called as monsoon. Okay. Let us discuss what is this differential heating. I already explained this before. I told you some time back why land gets hot quickly than water. Also, I told you why land gets cooled quickly than water. I told you many reasons for that, right? All of you know reasons, no? If it is land, if this is water, when sun rays are falling on both, land gets heated quickly because of number one, depth is less, water sun rays go deeper. Number two, water after getting heated will move away, but land stays there only. Number three, specific heat of water is more than specific heat of land. So there are reasons like that. So friends, now this concept is called as, that means land getting heated faster than water, land getting cooled also faster than water. This concept is called as differential heating of land and ocean. This differential heating is one of the reasons for monsoon. How? We will see. We will see how it is the reason. Dear friends, where is India? This is equator. Where is India? Above equator, below equator? Very good. I think all of you are intelligent. This is India. India is above equator. Okay. Now, friends, actually, if you take northern hemisphere is full of land, northern hemisphere. Southern is full of water. Anyhow, now, in the summer season, May, June, July, even April also, you can add April also. April, May, June, during the time, summer season, where is the sun? April, May, June. Sun will be here in the northern hemisphere. So, northern hemisphere gets heated, it becomes very hot. So, So in the summer season, friends, in summer season, if you take northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, northern hemisphere will be hot. During the same time, southern hemisphere will be cool. When it is summer for the north, it will be winter for the south. Because sun is away, no? Sun is here, no? So this is winter, cool. So southern hemisphere will be cool. Now, friends, tell me, when temperature is higher, pressure will be low. High temperature means all the air will rise up, pressure will become low. So here we have low pressure. Low pressure. Southern hemisphere will have one more thing you can tell is even if you consider the water here, see here. Even if you consider the northern hemisphere, the Indian land, Indian Ocean water, even if you consider those things also, in the some April, May, during this time, sun rays are falling on the northern hemisphere, which will become hotter, land or ocean? Land will become hotter. Ocean will still be cool only, because ocean takes more time. That's why even if you consider the Indian Ocean and India land will have low pressure, Indian Ocean will have high pressure. That also you can say. In that way also, friends, here you have high pressure, here low pressure. So tell me, winds will move from where to where? Yes, the winds move in this direction, high pressure to low pressure. That is called southwest monsoon. Southwest. Winds are coming from where? I told you, no. North, south, east, west. Winds are coming like this. They're coming from where? Southwest. They're coming from southwest. Okay? Because of differential heating. Sun is there above both. So see, sun will be in the entire northern hemisphere. But land is cool. Land is hot, water is cool. That's why you have southwest monsoon. Southwest monsoon. Friends, whereas in winter season, see, because of this, you have southwest monsoon in summer season. Whereas winter season, same concept, winter season, see, in the month of October, November, December, which will become cool easily? Land becomes cooler. But water, friend, doesn't, water, after taking all the heat, water cannot cool quickly. Because a lot of heat is there in the water, no? It cannot release the heat quickly. Because depth is more, no? So, water will still be hot only. When you take the land and water, land will become cool easily. Water is still warm only. That's why land will have high pressure, low pressure. High pressure, land has high pressure because cool, no? Water will have low pressure because it is warm, low pressure. That's why, friends, as this land is high pressure, water is low pressure, winds will move from where to where? Land to water. Winds move like this, land to water. That is called northeast monsoon. That's why you have northeast monsoon. Friend, I just told you only one reason till now. I have to tell another reason also. I told you differential heating. Remove the northern hemisphere, friend. Just keep land and ocean. Land, ocean. Let us discuss only about the northern hemisphere. Only Indian Ocean, India, that's all. Let's not look at northern hemisphere, that will come now. Now we'll come to that. As of now, remember that within the northern hemisphere, land and water, when you compare, how southwest monsoon winds are coming, how northeast monsoon is coming. Both you should know. Are you clear with both as of now? Anyone has a doubt till here? Why India has monsoon climate? One answer is differential heating of land water. Why India has a monsoon climate? Monsoon means seasonal reversal of winds. Why? One answer is heating of land and water. Now let's go to the second reason. The second reason, now I will tell you the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Now I will tell you. Listen carefully. सी, टेक अर्थ, टेक इक्वेटर, इंडिया इज हियर. आई टोल्ड यू दैट अलोंग द इक्वेटर यू विल हैव ए लो प्रेशर बेल्ट ओनली इन द मंथ ऑफ मार्च एंड सेप्टेंबर. नाउ टेक मार्च. इन द मार्च इक्वेटर विल हैव व्हाट? इक्वेटर विल हैव लो प्रेशर बेल्ट इन द मंथ ऑफ मार्च. एट द टाइम विच विंड्स विल ब्लो हियर? ट्रेड विंड्स. हियर ऑल्सो ट्रेड विंड. यू नो बोथ दिस विंड्स. यू नो नो बोथ विंड्स. यू नो राइट? ट्रेड विंड्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स ऑब्जर्व केयरफुल्ली. मार्च लो प्रेशर बेल्ट इज हियर. व्हेन यू गो टू अप्रैल, मे, जून, बाय द टाइम लो प्रेशर बेल्ट विल नॉट बी हियर. वेयर इट विल गो? इट विल गो हियर. द लो प्रेशर बेल्ट इज कमिंग हियर. लो प्रेशर बेल्ट and from the equator will be here only. Equator will never go away. Equator is center of the earth, that you should remember. Equator is center of the earth, but the low pressure belt is not on the equator, it is away from equator, it is almost top of India. Now this is low equatorial low pressure belt, this is subtropical subtropical high pressure belt. Friend, this is high pressure belt, this is low pressure belt. Now observe carefully friends. This is an interesting concept. Observe carefully. Why these winds are blowing in this direction? Actually, winds always want to blow from high pressure to low pressure in a straight way, right? Why they are moving towards the left? Courage force. In the which hemisphere? Southern hemisphere. But friends, when the same winds, when they cross the southern hemisphere, when they enter the northern hemisphere, their Coriolis force will be towards right hand side. So these winds will move towards, you understand, the second concept. That's why in the month of May, June, July, summer season, during the time, why India will get the southwest winds? In the month of May to September, why southwest monsoon comes to India? Why southwest monsoon comes to India? The reason is that equatorial low pressure belt will shift to India. So the trade winds cross the equator. Trade winds cross the equator and they move towards their right hand side. Okay, and what about the northeast trade winds? They'll be above this. See here, for example, this is low pressure belt. No, this is subtropical high pressure belt. Here trade winds will be there, above India it will be there, but looking in India we'll have mostly southwest monsoon. Now again come to winter season, come to October, November, that time. When it comes to October, November, the low pressure belt again come to south. So low pressure belt will come again here, low pressure belt. Here you have high pressure belt. So which winds will come on to India? In winter season, which winds will come? Northeast trade winds will come. So from October to March, when the equatorial low pressure belt goes below India, again the same northeast trade winds will come on to India. So October to March, again northeast trade winds will come on to India. That is called northeast monsoon. This is called northeast monsoon. So friends, I am repeating again, listen carefully. If this is India, in summer season you have southwest winds. In winter you have north, in summer you have southwest. Why? One reason is differential heating of land and ocean. Second reason is the low pressure belt goes above India. The equatorial low pressure belt goes above India. Shifting of the winds. Yeah, shifting of the pressure belt, shifting of the wind is one reason. Differential heating is another reason. Till now I told how many reasons for the monsoon? Two reasons. Now I'll tell you the third reason for Indian monsoon. Friends, Indian monsoon is a very important topic for UPSC, both in the world geography as well as Indian geography. Because why monsoon is important world geography, you know, monsoon is a very unique kind of climate, very different type of weather condition, not climate, weather condition, or long period average also, you can say climatic condition. Friends, monsoon is not only in India. See, if you take the world map, I'll take the world map, see.
Africa, Saudi Arabia, India, Europe, and take Australia, South America, North America, Alaska, Greenland.
Take the world map. In the world map, the entire Indian subcontinent has monsoon climate. Monsoon climate can be found in the Indian subcontinent and also Southeast Asia. Here, Southeast Asia also you find monsoon climate, Southeast Asia. It's very important. You should note these points. Also, some part of China will have monsoon climate. If you take Australia, the northern Australia will have monsoon climate. If you take USA, this is USA, southern USA, south of USA, will also have monsoon climate. If you take Africa, friends, western Africa will also have monsoon climate. Even Japan, if you take Japan, friends, one part of Japan will also have monsoon climate. So don't think that monsoon climate is only Indian phenomena. Indian subcontinent, some part of Japan and China, Southeast Asia, Northern Australia, Southern USA, Western Africa. See, it's important for prelims. Prelims is important, okay? Prelims point of view, you should know which are the places globally that are under the influence of monsoon climates or monsoon winds, okay? So, what is monsoon climate? Seasonal reversal of winds. What are the reasons for it? I told you two reasons. Now I am going to tell you the third reason for the Indian monsoon. Shall I tell you the third reason right now? Or you want a break? Huh? Okay. Friends, the third reason for Indian monsoon is circumpolar whirl.
The third reason is circumpolar whirl.
Whirl. Whirl means like this, rotation, whirl. What is whirlpool? Whirlpool is a famous bike. You know whirlpool bike? What is whirlpool? Washing machine. Whirlpool washing machine. Why it's called whirlpool? A swimming pool, kind of water, whirl. Whirl means rotation, whirl. So I think all of you know what means the whirl. Whirl means fast rotation of wind, water, whatever, whirl, okay? Now, circumpolar whirl, that means circumpolar. What is circumference? Circumference means complete circle, length of circle. Circumpolar means around the polar, there is a whirl. If you take Earth, it is a polar, around the pole, there is a movement of wind, like this, circumpolar wall. Do you know why it is coming, circumpolar wall, friends? Let me tell you why it is coming. For example, you take the polar area. What is this? Polar. In polar area, does the wind descend or ascend? Descend, no. Polar is high pressure belt, no. Polar is a high pressure. That means winds will subside. They descend. So winds, when winds are coming down, what is pressure here? High pressure. Where? In the lower atmosphere. But upper atmosphere? Low pressure. Friend, from the upper atmosphere, the winds are coming down. So there winds are not there. Coming down. So there it will be low pressure. Here? High pressure. So in the polar area, if this is a polar area, if you are right now, if you are all staying in the polar area, in the polar area, in the upper atmosphere, what will be there? Low pressure. Low pressure will be there. When low pressure is there, will all winds try to come into that or no? Come into that, no. For example,
if it's a low pressure area, all winds will try to.
Friends, water tries to come to the low potential area. Wind will come to low pressure area. All winds will try to come to low pressure area. Okay. As they are coming, because of Coriolis force, they cannot reach this. As they are coming, you know, rotates like this. Coming, rotates like this. Rotates like this. Finally, overall, it starts rotating like this. See. If any low pressure area is there, around the low pressure area, winds will move in the circle. Northern hemisphere anti-clockwise direction, southern hemisphere clockwise. That we will discuss later. Because Coriolis force. Based on the Coriolis force, in northern hemisphere, the low pressure area will have anti-clockwise winds. That is cyclone. What is cyclone? Cyclone is nothing but if there is a low pressure area, all winds will try to go there, but because of Coriolis force, they will deviate. So overall, they will start moving around the low pressure area, like this. That is called cyclonic condition. Now tell me, in the polar area, in the upper atmosphere, what will be there? Low pressure, cyclonic condition, because of which the winds will move like a whirl. That's why we call around the polar area. That's why we call it as a circumpolar whirl. Now friends, tell me, is it stronger in winter or summer? See, polar area will have more coldness in which season? Winter only, no? In winter season, when sun is far away, see, this is earth, no? In summer season, when sun is here, definitely polar area cannot be so strong. So circumpolar whirl will be only here. But in summer season, in winter season, when sun comes here, no, this becomes very strong. See, circumpolar whirl has become bigger. It almost comes to the latitude of 25 degree latitude. What is the latitude here? See, circumpolar whirl, which should be there in the polar area, comes till is north latitude. In which season?
Winter.
Winter only the polar area is stronger now. In summer it will become less cool. Summer. Okay. Now 25, which country is there? India is there. Now this circumpolar whirl comes to India in which season? Winter season. And it is one of the reasons for monsoon. I'll tell you how. See. Observe carefully, friends. Do you have any doubt till here? Any doubt till here? You have doubts only if you understand now. However, you don't understand. That's why you don't have doubts. You can raise your hands. Don't worry. Okay. Friends, listen. See. Which season shall we consider?
Winter season.
In winter season, friends, by the way, circumpolar whirl is not at the surface, upper atmosphere. See, previously I told you about the northeast wind, westerly, southwest winds. These winds are surface winds, surface. But now circumpolar whirl is upper atmospheric. The previous two reasons, no, differential heating and cooling, press shift pressure belts. At that time, I am talking only about the surface. But now third reason telling, you know, circumpolar whirl. This is upper atmosphere. So you try to think differently. Third reason is different. Upper atmospheric whirl. Okay. Now, friends, in upper atmosphere rotating, no? Now I am in India. Winter season. Winter season, I am standing in India. I am looking above. There is circumpolar whirl, which I cannot see. But it will be there. It will be there, okay? Circumpolar whirl will be there. It's a low pressure, high pressure. Actually, it is low pressure, but you know what happens here? Here, as they come to India, we call them as the jet stream. Why jet stream, you know? Actually, friends, actually, jet stream is nothing but upper atmospheric winds, not the lower atmosphere. Upper atmosphere, some 10 kilometers higher, 10 to 12 kilometers high. There are some winds blowing there. Some winds. Mostly they blow from west to east only. So that means they blow like this. They blow like this. That's why they're called as westerlies. I mean, in Asia. In Asia, jet stream is a westerly. Upper atmospheric westerly, not normal westerly. Upper atmosphere westerly, okay? Now, friends, this upper atmospheric westerly, when it blows over India, Himalayas will block them. Himalayas are there now, like Himalayas. When the jet streams are coming, jet streams hit the Himalayas, they divide into two branches. Friends, this is Himalaya, okay? They hit now, one branch goes to north of Himalaya. Other branch comes to the south of Himalaya. South Himalaya, okay? Now, south of Himalaya affects India mostly. India is south of Himalaya, north of Himalaya, India? North of Himalaya, na? Himalaya is on north of India, okay. But India is on south of Himalaya. So friends, we take India, the Himalayas, no? When the jet streams hit the Himalayas, because Himalayas are almost 8 kilometers, you know. They divide into two branches. Jet streams divide into two branches. One branch goes to the northern Himalaya, other branch southern Himalaya. Now friends, these jet streams actually create high pressure. In the upper atmosphere, they create high pressure. See, forget about the circumpolar low pressure world. That low pressure is there in the polar area. But now it became bigger. Finally, in India, just consider the winds. Some winds are blowing in India. Called as jet stream. Actually, they don't move in a straight fashion. They move like this. Jet streams. Do you know who found that? A scientist called Rossby found that. Rossby. That's why they're called as Rossby waves. They're called as Rossby waves. Upper atmospheric winds called jet streams or Rossby waves do not move straight. Do not move linearly. They move in a curved fashion. Like waves. They are like waves. Okay? Now friends, upper atmosphere. Okay. Now, these waves actually create high pressure above India. Above India, what do they create? High pressure. Now, listen carefully. Now, April month has come. Which month has come? In April month, is it summer or winter? It will be hot or cool? It will be hot. Summer. So in April month, the land becomes hot. When land becomes hot, the wind has to rise up. There should be rainfall now. But do you find rainfall in April? No. In May. In May also, it is very hot. But rainfall won't be there. Will rainfall there in the May? Rainfall come only in the June. Why? April, May, it is so hot, no? Hot means low pressure, no? Then rainfall has to happen, no? Why it's not happening? Do you know why? April and May, though it is very hot, still you have those? Hey, don't tell me like this, one girl looking like this. See, look at my hand only, okay? Friends, in the April and May, though the land is hot, pressure is low, the winds cannot rise up, they cannot. Because at the top, what is there? High pressure. High pressure, Rossby waves. Friends, when high pressure is there, can winds go to high pressure? Winds can never go to high pressure. Here it may be hot, but they cannot go. Understand? For example, take a vacuum cleaner. Okay? Put in the mouth. Okay? The vacuum cleaner takes, it sucks all things. Okay? Now when you take the vacuum cleaner, you try to suck the vacuum cleaner. You cannot do it. It is more powerful than you. It will take you. Like that, though here low pressure is there, though here high temperature is there, the winds won't rise up. They cannot rise up because here high pressure. That's why, friend, in the month of April and May, though temperature is very high, winds do not rise up and there is no rainfall. Only in the month of June, rains will start. You know why? By the month of June, the Rossby waves will go back to the polar area. Actually, they are in the polar area only. They come to India in the winter season. In the winter, they come to India. They will stay till May, they will stay. By June, again, they will go to the polar area. That's why in the June, once the Rossby waves go away from India, no, suddenly on top of India, low pressure will be there, low pressure. Immediately, winds will rise. Rainfall will occur. Rainfall occurs. Okay? So, this is the third reason, friend. Third reason for monsoon is the circumpolar world and associated jet streams westerly jet streams and the high pressure they create in the upper atmosphere. High pressure, upper atmosphere. Whereas in the month of June, July, they create low pressure. As they move away, it gives low pressure. Then rainfall occurs from June to October. Again from October, again they will come. Again there is no rainfall. Okay? Is it clear till now? But now I will tell you one thing which may be slightly confusing for you. That's why you should listen more carefully now. Now I am going to the next point, most important point. In the winter season, which winds will blow above India in the upper atmosphere? Jet streams. They blow from west to east, east to west. West to east. That means this India, they come from the Mediterranean Sea. Mediterranean Sea is the west of India, east of India. Mediterranean Sea is on the west of India. They come from Mediterranean Sea to India. When they are coming from Mediterranean Sea to India in the winter season, when they are coming like this, in Mediterranean Sea there are some cyclones. They are temperate cyclones, which I will discuss later, but just remember that in the winter season in Mediterranean Sea there are some cyclonic depressions. These Rossby waves will bring them to India. Not entire India, only, for example, if you take India, they come only to Punjab, Haryana, maximum up to Patna, that's all, up to Bihar, this part. So they bring cyclones from Mediterranean Sea to Northwest India, Northwest India. That's why in winter season, sometimes you find rainfalls in Punjab, Haryana, UP, Bihar, you find rainfall. Have you found rainfall? If you don't find, please find them, because it will be there. Okay, friends, these are called winter rains. Generally in India, winter season should not have rainfall. No, India rainfall should be from May, June to September. But in the winter season, December, January, February, you sometimes find rainfall in Northwest India. Who is bringing them? Jet streams. From where they are bringing them? Mediterranean Sea. This is a very important bit for prelims, as well as when you write answer on jet streams, effects of jet streams on India. The question can be, for example, take a question. What are the effects of westerly jet streams on India? What are jet streams? What are jet streams? What are the effects of westerly jet streams on India? Understand? Write the answer for this question in the home. But water effects you write, you should write, in the winter season they create high pressure above India, hence no rainfall. In summer season they leave India, hence low pressure and rainfall. In winter season they bring the Mediterranean cyclonic depressions to India and create rainfall in the Northwest India. And they hit the Himalayas, break into two branches. Generally, some points you can write. Like that, you have to write the answer. What are jet streams? You should write. They are upper atmospheric, upper tropospheric winds blowing from west to east in Asia. They are a part of circumpolar whirl. They are a part of circumpolar whirl, which extends to India during the winter season. It will stay on India till May. It will leave only in June. They move like waves called Rossby. You should write all these points. Understand? So that is the question. Now, similarly, friends, a prelims question. Prelims. Which of the following is not a reason for monsoon? Which of the following is not a reason for Indian monsoon? Option A, differential heating and cooling of land and ocean. First option is differential heating and cooling of land and ocean. Second option is westerly jet streams. Westerly jet streams. Third option is shifting of pressure belts. Shifting of pressure belts. Fourth reason is, I have to think fourth reason. Fourth reason is ocean currents. Ocean currents. What is the answer? Yes. Ocean current is not a reason for Indian monsoon. In fact, Indian monsoon is a reason for ocean currents. Indian monsoon affects the ocean currents. Ocean currents do not affect the Indian monsoon. That you should know. How Indian monsoon affects ocean currents will be taught in oceanography. If you say Indian Ocean, no? From June to September, ocean currents will be like this. See, ocean currents like this. June to September. October to March, ocean currents will be like this. Okay? Friends, any prelims objective question or main subjective question in geography, physical geography, will be based on concepts. But along with the concept, you should draw diagrams, you should use the right words. You should use the words. Tropical jet streams, Rossby wave, circumpolar well. You cannot write some winds are coming from north, they blow above the air, which you cannot see. They will carry some depression from, you should not write like that. You have to use the right language in geography. Okay. But no need to buy at it. So understand it and remember important terms and some diagrams are enough. This is not optional now. You don't write too much. Okay. Now, friends, I should tell you an interesting concept called as equatorial westerlies. What is that? How many of you are really bored of this topic? Raise your hands. After I'm gone, raise your hands. Friends, listen. What are equatorial westerlies? And are they the reason for monsoon? Let us see. Yes, they are the reason. Now I am telling the fourth reason. I am telling which reason now? Fourth reason for Indian monsoon. Friends, listen carefully. First of all, you should know intertropical convergence zone. Intertropical convergence zone. What is it? Let us see. What is this? Oh, Talvi Sathol. Okay. Now, this is equator. Which winds will move here? Northeast? Northeast trade winds. Which winds will move here? Southwest? Hey, southeast winds. See, actually I am trying to test you, okay? Now friends, see. What is this? Southeast? Friends, the northeast trade winds and southeast trade winds collide. They hit each other and then they will rise up. Like this, okay? Now friends, this zone where they both collide is called convergence. They are converging now. Intertropical. This is tropical. Tropic of Cancer, Capricorn, tropic. Intertropical convergence zone. Now, tell me, will this ITC, intertropical, will it always be at the equator? No. For example, in the month of June, if this is the equator, the low pressure will be at? Low pressure will be here. If low pressure is here, in the month of June, the winds will, see the winds. So this is intertropical. Of course, these winds will not blow like this. Because see, though they want to blow like this, after crossing equator, they will. But whatever way they blow, doesn't matter. Finally, they both will converge. So intertropical convergence zone will come to the north. Friends, remember, when, this is an interesting concept, listen. Now when, at the low pressure area, these winds are converging, no? Converging, no? There will be some feeble winds blowing like this. Why they blow? Nobody knows, but they'll blow. Along the intertropical convergence zone, though the wind rises up, more rise up, some wind will not rise up. It will stay there only. It will stay there. It will move from west to east. We call those winds as equatorial westerlies. So equatorial westerlies are the winds that are found in the intertropical convergence zone. That's all. What is it? Okay. Now friends, these equatorial westerlies in the month of June will come to India. The entire thing is coming to India, no? Month of June. Entire shifting is there, no? So, in the month of June, if this is equator, if this is India, if this is the intertropical convergence zone, westerlies are, see, westerlies want to blow like this only, okay? Whatever, like this, whatever. So these winds are called as southwest monsoons. So some say, some geographers, meteorologists, or whatever you want to call it as, they say that in the June, July, August, during the time, the southwest monsoon, the winds, no, western winds, are nothing but they are westerlies. And do you know what they say? One more point, very important point, friends. They say that in the monsoon time, will you get rainfall every day for 6 months, June to October? No, right? Today rainfall, continue for 3 days, it stops. For 10 days, no rainfall. Again rainfall, again stops. Friends, this is called actually monsoon break. Monsoon break means rain break, spell and break, whatever. Okay? So friends, do you know why it occurs? They say that when the trade winds collide, they rise up, no? At some places, when they collide, rise up, they create low pressure area. At some places, they create low pressure area. And that is not a continuous process. Sometimes they may create, sometimes they may not create. Whenever they create, there will be rainfall. That's why monsoon rainfall does not occur every day for 6 months, June to October. Whenever low pressure is created, because of ITCZ. Whenever low pressure is created, on those 3-4 days, rainfall will be there. That is the reason. That's why ITC is also a reason for Indian monsoon. See, there are a lot of reasons for Indian monsoon, and even today nobody knows which is the exact reason. Really, even I also don't know. That's why I'm telling all reasons. Okay? Friends, see, one reason is different shifting of, other reason is shifting of, other reason is circumpolar, other reason is equatorial and intertropical convergence zone. Okay. If you want to find new reason, please find out. After clearing the exam, find out. Now you don't have time. Okay. Well, friends, any doubts still here? Is monsoon topic clear for all of you? Is the winds, pressure belts, this is very clear for you? Or you have some gaps? If you have gaps, you can ask me. Okay. See you, friends. Take care. Bye.